walk to your left until you find another statue of Kala Bhairava in a sitting position. Here, Lord Shiva is holding a sharp weapon in his hand. He is holding a skull in his right hand. As you look around the figure, you will see many skeletal-like creatures depicted around the bottom. Enjoy the intricate carvings in stone to show the look of Lord Shiva and the surroundings. On your right, you can see another intricately carved statue of Lord Shiva slaying a demon by trampling with his strong feet. The demon being trampled is begging for mercy. As you take a turn and enter the next section, you can look at another Kala Bhairava statue. Diagonally opposite to this is another statue of Kala Bhairavi. Immediately after this, there is another sculpture of Lord Krishna lifting Govardhan Mountain. You can breeze through the next section. Stop when you come across a dancing Shiva statue. You will not miss it, as this is a sculpture at the corner of the section. This statue is on the left of a huntress statue who is posing with her bow in air. Please pay attention to the statue of Shiva. Here you can see that he has spread the skins of elephant as canopy and is dancing furiously after slaying the elephant. Elephant is nothing but demon Gajasura. This is a depiction of Gaja Charmambadara or Shiva in an act of wearing the elephant demon skin around him. Just next to this, you will find another form of Shiva called Ardhanarishvara, or the form where Shiva has an anatomy of both man and a woman. 2 to 3 paces towards the left, you will find another statue of Arjuna trying to aim for the fish on the ceiling. In the adjacent wall, at the end of the section and just around the corner, you can see another sculpture of Vishnu in Trivikrama form, raising his giant foot in the air. Look at the detailed carvings by the artisans. Pay attention to the ornamentation and the designs within the dressing of the Lord. The bracelets around each of the feet are also carved very beautifully. As you turn around the corner, the first sculpture that you see is of demon Ravana lifting Mount Kailash. If you observe carefully, you can find a lot of comparisons with the mountain carvings that Ravana is lifting and that Krishna is lifting in Govardhana Giridhari depiction that you saw sometime before. As you move to your left, you will find figurines playing Dol in the next couple of sculptures that follow when you continue walking towards your left. At the center, you will find another big sculpture of Lord Shiva and Parvati. Again, pay special attention to the filigree work in the background of this sculpture. The seat that Lord and Goddess are sitting is also intricately carved with many decorations. In the middle section, you will see a sculpture of Lord Brahma with 4 heads and long beard. Just pass next 2 statues onto your left. You will find one more big sculpture of Uma Maheshwar, where Lord Shiva and Parvati are sitting on sacred Nandi. Take your time to appreciate the carvings on the Nandi, especially at the decoration on the back, forehead, neck, face and horns. Very intricately carved. As you turn to your left, you will notice that you have come to the end of the third shrine. You will also notice that the bigger sculptures also end after this section. In this section, the first statue on the rightmost side is another sculpture of Shiva. Towards the end, there is a Varaha sculpture. You can continue your leftward journey and reach the eastern entrance. That concludes our tour of temple exterior. As you can see, there are a lot of similarities in the sculptures of gods and goddesses with that of Hoysaleshwar and Shantaleshwar temple. Kedareshwara temple, though not often visited by tourists, nevertheless is as grandiose as that of the other Halebidu temple.